This is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. I was out eating my lunch here, cucumbers and greens, and then I picked up a little visitor, and I don't know if you could see him there on the camera. This is a baby praying mantis, and this is a beneficial insect in our garden, and I'm happy he's on me, and I'm happy he's going to be in my garden and hanging out here for his life. I did buy praying mantis eggs and put them in different parts of my garden, and you know, when it heats up, they hatch. And, you know, when the baby praying mantises are born, they actually eat each other. So it's the strongest survive. And now that they're alive, he'll be hanging out here for his life. And hopefully he'll, or she, will lay an egg. And there'll be more praying mantises. So I had a couple lay an egg, and it was really cool when they lay an egg. But I'm happy he's here, or she's here, and in my garden to eat all the bugs. So we're going to go ahead and put this little one back down. Okay, little guy. All right, there he goes. We're going to let him hang out. And then, you know, if you use pesticides and spray pesticides on your stuff, pesticides are non-discriminatory. You know, many pesticides will kill all pests, and they may not be that selective. So if you use natural pesticides, sometimes they target only certain ones. So, you know, there's definitely good bugs and bad bugs, and we don't want to be killing the good bugs. So, spray some good stuff. So that's why actually I minimally spray. I only spray in isolated areas if totally required. Otherwise, I just actually don't spray at all. This is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And, you know, say hi to your praying mantises for me.